Michael Goodwin, Pulitzer Prize winning columnist for the New York Post. He's been on the program. He says the media is, quote, torching its own standards to cover the election. Most of it in favor of Hillary, he says. Here's the headline. Here's what it says, New York Post. Hillary's media is torching its standards to cover the election. That's what he's saying this morning. Lee Carter is with us. But just for a second, Lee, I want to turn this around. What do you think the media would be saying this morning if it were Donald Trump who'd stumbled, collapsed, shoved into his vehicle, leaves a shoe in the road, etc., etc., etc.? What do you think?
Well, I think that we all know what they'd be saying. They'd say it's another example of why Donald Trump is unfit to be president. I think they'd be going absolutely nuts over this. And I do believe that there's apologists for Hillary Clinton. There's people who are making excuses for her constantly, for nothing to see here, the emails are getting overblown, all of this sort of thing where people, you know, her supporters, or Donald Trump supporters, are being criticized for questioning Hillary Clinton. It doesn't go the other way around. And I just think that this is really, really unfortunate. I think that actually, it's backfiring in many ways. I think that Donald Trump supporters are saying, I see what's going on here, and this is exactly what I'm tired of. I'm tired of the establishment and the elites pushing their own agenda and not listening to me.
And calling me a racist, sexist, homophobe, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera.
I mean, that is one of the most outrageous comments I have ever heard by any candidate ever. Because you can attack your opponent, but to attack their supporters, 50 million Americans, and if you want to say it's half of them, 25 million Americans, it's absolutely outrageous, and it's going to make her really even more unpopular.
Liz, you brought us a story, you brought me a story earlier. A writer for the Huffington Post was fired, he says, because he raised the issue of Hillary's health back in August.
Yeah,
that's accurate?
His name is David Seaman. He says that they fired him for that he was questioning her health repeatedly, and that he claims he got fired because of that.
This goes back to the media's approach to the whole election. They're in the tank for Hillary. That would be my opinion.
I wouldn't disagree with you. I think
good.
I would never disagree with you. I just think that it is really, really. The thing that I also find amazing is that Americans are having a hard time saying out loud that they are voting for Donald Trump because of the criticism they get for supporting him.
The backlash.
This is one more example of that.
And exactly.
I think that
what it is.
And that's why you see in online polls versus telephone polls, Donald Trump support, you know, he performs way better in online polls than telephone polls because people aren't saying it out loud.
It's like
because the media is causing it to be outrageous.
It's the Brexit thing
it's
all
exactly
over again. Because
right.
you were racist and uneducated if you voted for Brexit.